Hi, Shrent. Once again, we met to continue our class. Today, we are going to talk about changes around us. What about we are going to talk about? Changes around us. We know well about that changes. So, what is the mean of changes? What is the mean of changes? We may observe in our day-to-day life, where we are looking to others or where we are looking to our atmosphere, we may use the particular word changes. Our atmosphere becomes changed, the color changed, why your face is changed, is it or not? But sometimes we may utilize the word changes. Then wow means how the word we may observe in our surroundings. Changes around us, how it will change us, what type of changes are there in our surroundings. Okay, we may know well about what are the changes are there in our surroundings. Day and night is one of the change. Seasons are the one of the changes. The leaves are growing. Okay, and blossom of flowers, ripening of fruits. Is it or not? Such a different are there in our surroundings to change. Now we are feeling as a warm, and within soon we may feel, after next second we may feel cool. The atmosphere changes, the weather changes, climate changes. See here, the milk converts into the curd, it is one of the change. The burning of coal, it is one of the change. See here what we are talking about. So many changes are there in our surroundings. So many changes are there in our surroundings. We may observe what we can while we are eating food. Some dog or any spill means a sprinkle on our floor, means otherwise on our cloth. After washing with soap, we may get a different color. Before it was in yellow. After washing with soap, it becomes a red color. The color changes from one color to another. Then why is it changes? Okay? And also we can observe in different crops growing, different changes are there in the surrounding. Crops growing, and what we can say, the leaves are growing in the plant, growth of the person. Okay? And also what we can say about that, different colors in the sky. See, so many changes are there in our surroundings. Then we'll list out some of the changes, what are there in our surroundings, what we may observe those surroundings. In the crop, what we can say, in the crop, growing in the field, growing in the field, falls off leaves, falls off leaves. Okay? And also what we can, the growth of fresh leaves. See here, what I'm saying, fall of leaves, the growth of fresh means new leaves. Okay? And coming to that, fresh leaves on trees. And coming to talk about change in the color of the sky, change in the color of sky, change in the color of sky. Now, so what we can talk about, flowers bloom. And then, what we can say, wither away. Wither away. See here, What I'm saying, different general, what I'm saying, you know, general field, you know, field or crop growing the field means the falls of leaves. The leaves will fall down and the new leaves or fresh leaves comes on the tree. And changing the color of sky, we know well about that. At morning and evening, then noontime, the sky appears in different colors. Morning and evening, it appears in the orange or red color. Noontime, it appears in white color. Generally, you may consider sky in blue color. Is it or not? So, flowers bloom. What I'm saying to you, flowers bloom. Bloom means produce, yield flowers. Bloom means produce, yield flower. Means blossom. What we can say? What we can say? Blossom. Then what about whether is a dry or dead? What we can say? Dry or dead. Okay? Dry or dead. Okay. See here what I am saying. The bloom of flowers or death of flowers, means wither of flowers, is also one of the change we may observe in our surroundings. We may observe in our surroundings. Of course, so many of changes are there in our different surroundings. What are those? Some more changes are there. What we can observe those changes? See here. Increase length of nails. Of course, the nails after coating, it also may grow. And also what we can say, and hair increase or decrease in there. And also what we can, nails and hair. And also one more, we can increase or decrease weight. Increase or decrease of weight. It is also one of the change. Is it? Of course, we may observe that. And also one more, we can, and also increasing height. And also increasing height. See what type of changes we are observing. For other changes, some changes can be seen by our eyes, some changes cannot be seen by our eyes. There are different changes are there. So see here, generally what we are eating, the curd, it changes from the milk. Is it milk converts into the curd? It is one of the change. But we can't see with our natural eye where this process going to change curd from milk. The product that yield we may particle to identify, we may feel to identify, then the change somewhere is possible, somewhere not possible to see with our natural eye. Okay? And also what are the different seasons also we can say about changes is going around the earth, and the day and night also going. See here, so many are there, different type of, what you can say, different type of changes are there in our surroundings. And also what we can say, what are the different are there? The changes are in two different types. One is physical change, one is chemical change. Before to talk about that chemical change and physical change, one is the temporary change, one is a permanent change. Changes are in two different types. One is temporary change, one is a permanent change. To talk about those, some more changes we know well. After cutting the fruit, by placing some means some interval of time, we may observe the outer surface lesion, where we thought that through the inner part is made forms in different colors. While throwing iron or metal substances in open atmosphere or iron materials at an open atmosphere, after some days, we may observe the nail consists of an outer layer formed around the iron nail, means that wastage or that we are calling rust or corrosion. Rust is formed on the iron nail due to the reaction between metal to the oxygen, which is present in humidity. Okay? But the different changes are there in our dead surroundings. To talk about that each and every change, what is happening surrounding. Okay, let's see, understand what are the changes are present in our surroundings in our day-to-day life by individual changes to discuss. Okay, see here, let me talk about that the best change in our life, our best example to understand the change, which is that the milk converts into the curd. Milk converts into the curd. See that how it will be. Yeah, to understand the changes, what are happening in our surroundings, we are going with a particular change, what is taking in our real life, in our day-to-day life, that is nothing as milk into curd, changing of milk into curd. See here, we know about that, the curd is prepared from milk, what we know that? We know, curd, prepared from milk. Of course, making curd is our common experience. Curd is prepared in almost every house, of course. Is it or not? It is a general experience and it can be prepared by every form. Nowadays, we are ready to make, ready to buy or whatever, which is already filled in a package. Okay, but so many houses are ready to prepare with their own experience. So that's why so many houses, the curd is preparing in so many houses. Then how to prepare that? Generally, curd is prepared by adding. What mark? Behind experience goes, see here what I'm saying to you. Generally, see here what I'm saying. Curd prepared from milk, of course, we know well about that. curd is prepared by, how curd is prepared by adding a very small quantity, a very small quantity of curd to the bowl containing warm milk. So what we are doing here, by taking milk into a bowl, which is helping to cook, which is helping to boil, what we can say, boil. See, this is what I'm saying to you, milk. Those we are boiling at a particular temperature, giving heat energy, to boil the milk. At a particular temperature, it boils to give also that milk from outer surface. So that milk we are making to decrease the temperature means we are placing at a side without disturbing, to decrease the heatness, to decrease the hot sense. When it becomes as a warm, milk, means now it is in hot. Now the temperature is decreased by placing at a particular place. It decreases the temperature, then becomes warm. When it is warm, we are adding a small quantity of the curd. We're adding small quantity of curd into the warm milk. See here how to make the curd from milk. We are adding a small quantity of the curd, a few amount of the curd, we are adding into the warm milk, which is filled in a bowl, Understand? See here, the milk is, after adding the curd, into the warm milk, the milk should, what you can say, well, or mix well. Means what we can say here, means the milk is stirred well. Stirred means what you have to mix well. Means what we added, that quantity of curd, the small quantity of curd, we are saying the sample curd. That is, you are saying sample curd. That should be mixed throughout the milk. That's why we have to give shake to the milk, warm milk. Then the curd will distribute throughout the warm milk. See here, what I'm saying to you, after adding that small quantity of the curd, into the warm milk, what we are doing here, the milk is stirred well. After stirring that, what you have to do, then the bowl containing milk with the, sample curd means we added some quantity of curd into the warm milk. No, that's why after taking that, after stirring that, the bowl containing warm milk and also sample curd, what we added is what we can say covered by a lid. But we can use lid and kept still. Undisturbed. What we can say, undisturbed for few hours. To get curd. Is it visible to you? Yeah. See what we are doing? Changing of milk into curd. means making a curd by using milk. We know curd prepared from milk, of course. What we are doing here, curd is prepared by, we are preparing a curd. Curd is prepared by adding a very small quantity of curd. A very small quantity of curd to the bowl containing warm milk. We are adding a small quantity of curd into the milk which is filled in a bowl. And then what we are doing, the bowl, see here, the milk is filled well, we are mixing clear, means the curd should distribute throughout the milk. That's why we are giving, stirring, mixing without placing any by shaking. Then the bowl containing milk which is a sample curd. Because of the bowl already consists of milk, after that what we added, sample curd means some quantity of the curd we added into the milk, that we call sample curd. Okay, the both, what happened? The both milk, the bowl containing milk with the sample curd, those covered with a, are covered by a lid. Lid means a pan. Lid means what we can say? Pan. Lid means pan. Okay, and kept still and undisturbed for few hours. We should not give any disturbance to that bowl which is containing milk and sample curd. Then it gives curd after some interval of time. It gives curd in after some interval of time. By that, we can get a curd from the milk. Okay, note on that. Yeah, students. See here, we learned how to make curd from milk. We observed a change in milk into curd. We are observing a change around us. We are observing a change around us. It is for syllabus for online test. What is that? Online test. So after finishing this, we observed how to make, what is the change present, how it is taking. Then let's we compare milk and curd. Let's we compare milk and some curd. Because what are the changes observed? What are the changes are present than curd prepared from milk. What is the property? Means the properties of milk came to the curd or not. Whether the property of milk and whether the properties of means the whether the properties of milk and curd both are same or different or not are the same. Let me talk about those. Let me compare what milk and curd. Milk and curd. Coming to that, comparing milk and curd. Comparing milk and curd. We know about that first change we are observing color. What is the first change? Changes. First is a color. Second is first change is a color, and next is a taste. Next is a taste, and then taste. What we can say taste. Next one is a taste. First color, taste. And taste, and then also we can observe weight. What changes we can observe? Color, taste, and also color, taste, weight, and what we can say? Odor. Odor means what we can say? Smell. Odor means smell. Okay, those changes we can observe. See here, how to observe those changes. Let's we talk about that. So take some milk in your bowl. Take some milk in a bowl and some curd in another bowl, and some curd in another bowl. Compare the color of what we are going by. Compare the color of both. Means milk and curd. Milk and curd. Coming to that, what we can compare, milk in white color, but curd also in white, but slight different color. Slight, not in exactly white. So what we can say here, slight. So what we can hear, we may notice, there is a slight difference in color. Difference in color from milk to curd. What we are saying here, we are taking some curd and milk in a different beakers. One milk in one beaker, curd in one beaker. Milk in one beaker, curd in one beaker. And compare the color of both. We are comparing milk and curd color while we took in the both bowls. We may notice that There is a slight difference in color from milk to curd. Milk in white, all of it is curd, and curd is, of course, it appears as in white, but it is a different color compared to the milk. Means not exactly in white, it is changes its white color somewhat. White changes. Slight, very few, a little color changes, not appears in exactly white color. Okay? So, color we observed, what is the color of milk and what is the color of curd. And coming to the talk about next, we have to go by taste. We have to talk about taste. Let's talk about taste. What is the taste? Now take the milk and curd in separate. Now take some milk and curd separate teaspoons and taste them. So what we are doing here, we are going to taste those. We are going to make a taste before we observe in color. Generally, when we observe, while we are tasting milk and curd, milk is in the sweet taste. What we can observe? Milk in sweet taste, but curd is in what a sour taste. What you can say? Curd in sour taste. Highly curd in most of sour in taste. The curd most of are highly in sour taste and milk in sweet taste. So coming to that, what we can talk about here, in the taste of milk, means we may notice that milk is somewhat, that milk is somewhat sweet, and what we can say, curd can be slightly or highly sour in taste. Is that visible to you? Sour in taste. Okay. See that. Yeah. What we are observing? We observe here two type of changes. One is color, one is the taste. One is in color, one is in taste. How the color we observed? The milk in white, curd is not in white exactly, slight different color. And taste, what we can, milk is somewhat in sweet, but curd can be slightly or highly, very less or highly. Most of it appears in sour taste. What we can observe, milk in sweet, curd in sour taste. So we learn the changes from milk to curd. One is color, one is taste. Those curd generally prepared from milk. But the curd not got similar properties of the milk. The curd is a property of the product of the milk, but the milk properties are not belongs to the curd properties. What we discussed up to two. Okay, note on that. Coming to that, so what changes we observe from milk to curd, color change and taste also changed. Then remain what is there. Let's talk about those. Okay. Coming to talk about those, what are that? Okay. Now, coming to that, touch the milk and touch the milk means we are holding that milk under the curd and the curd. See here what I am saying to you, by touching the milk and the curd with our finger, with our hand, we may feel milk in completely in liquid, but curd, it is not in the liquid, it appears in the semi-solid. It appears in the semi-solid. See here. Yeah, what we are talking about, we are talking about states. Whether we have three states of matter, we have three states of matter. One is solid state, liquid state, and another one is a gas state. So in these three states of matter, in that three states of matter, what we are observing, so in that milk and curd, we are comparing with our fingers. By holding with our fingers, the milk appears in liquid form and curd appears in semi-solid. Semi-solid. And coming to that, to talk about next thing is a weight. What about next? Weight. So how to identify weight? See here, now measure the level of curd and milk by taking in a bowl. So by taking in a bowl, we may observe by comparing the weight of the milk and the curd with equal value by taking a bowl, we may observe the weight is different compared to the milk and curd. The milk consists less in weight than to the curd. So the curd consists more weight and liquid milk consists lower weight. By comparing the weight of milk and the curd, what we may compare? Those two are having different weight. Those who are having different ways. And coming to that odor. Odor means smell. Odor means smell. We know well about that. The milk, the smell of milk and the smell of curd is quite different. Is it or not? We can easily identify the smell of curd and smell of milk. The smell of curd and milk also are quite different. See what I'm saying? Only in the color, slightly different we are observing in state, taste, weight, odor or smell. We are observing quite opposite difference or changes from milk to curd. Generally, we may learn the substance which are made from, the substance which made from a particular material, that material property should belong to the substances. But what we are observing, the changes are not belongs to the their products. The curd is a product of milk. Curd is a product of milk, but the milk properties are not belongs to the curd property because of their quite whole properties. What we discussed, five properties are quite different for the milk to curd. Okay, what we discussed, color is slightly different, milk in white, curd in slight, not exact in white. Okay, state, milk in liquid and curd in semi-solid, and taste, so milk in slight sweet, somewhat sweet taste of milk, and curd appears highly or slightly, it is in the sour taste, most of sour taste, and weight, the milk and curd weight both are different value, we are comparing each with equal value, and odor or smell, their smells are both are in quite different opposite to that. So the milk smell and water milk curd smell both are different, not in the same. What we observe here, the properties of the substances which we prepared from each, those are not suitable. Means the curd is a product of milk, but the properties of curd is not belongs to a, not come by the water mother product, means what we can say milk. Understand? So note on that, what we learn, there is a changes from one product to another, one substance to another. Okay, what changes taking in our surrounding, that we are talking. Okay, with the next topic, with the next change, we will see in the next class to understand how it changes seasons, how the seasons are changing in our surrounding, how it is impact on our life. Okay, so we learn in the next class that, so we practice that for online test. See in the next class. Keep in learning. Have a good day to you.